Good morning, everybody.
And howdy, cardies. How exciting you're listening to Miss Chrissy.
And Susie.
And we are the...
I was going to say Wild Girls. I was going to say the Naughty Girls, but I'll say the Wild Girls.
Well, we are so excited, Cece. And why are we so excited?
Because we've got Chris Bootsley.
Yep. Our cowdy boy. Now, where's Boots coming in from? From Texas? Come on, Kavara.
I can't remember.
What do you mean you can't remember?
I've got it in front of you, but I'm
She can't do the two things. Where's he from?
Virginia.
Get
those teeth out.
I know, I didn't brush my teeth this morning. So what have you been up to this week, Miss Cece? No more hot dates?
No.
Somebody was asking me about your dates.
Why?
Well, they just wanted to know, and I said, I'm not telling.
No, believe me, they're not hot.
What was the one that you ran with your hair on fire?
No, that's the one I nearly went through the fence. If I could have jumped over, I would have.
When are you going to learn never go on a blind date, Kavara?
I know.
What time do you get up to put your eyelashes on?
4:00.
Oh, I told you.
4 a.m.
What's going on with my chair? On his way. Yeah. Boots is on his way with his guitarist, who I do not know your name, guitarist, but
I do, but it's in my phone and I forgot.
Of course it is.
I reckon this is the best version. You don't have to like it. It's UB40, but it's a black guy they got in it. I need some red wine.
Thank God that song's over. Oh, did I say that?
That's a great version.
I'm not that excited about that song.
Are you?
No.
Oh, I loved it.
Well, we have very different musical tastes, don't we, Miss?
Yeah, Miss, you like Santa. Singing ho, ho, ho.
You are one little bag. I could knock its head off. You're listening to 96.5 in your FM. Kavara's been very, very naughty out there. We are the Wild Girls.
Why are you giving me that? Well, Chrissy and Susie.
Oh, that little old chestnut. And you're just listening to one of Cece's mix. I don't mind UB40. I kind of like them, but I hated that.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I love it.
Cece's got her dreadlocks on this morning. Will they open up the lines again for the win a date with Cece competition?
No.
Or is that over?
No, never.
Never again. Never again. Wanted to hear Anonymous Curry.
No, that's your song.
Forever and ever.
My sister used to look like her when she was young. Sorry, Anne.
I don't know that that's a compliment. If you had said sung like her, that might be good. But look, might not be great. Okay. Just an empty chair. Nothing else is empty.
Again.
Boots, released an EP before this. Mm-hmm. I've got to put my specs on because I like looking at you, but these are just magnifiers, and now I've got to look at you and read because...
Crank It Up's actually my fourth album, if you count singles and such.
Yeah. And what a gorgeous album it is.
Thank you.
You must be proud of that because we get a lot of feedback about playing your songs and people just love it. You got that real...
Friend
you know,
Ray Whitlock in America.
Draw.
He's probably on his way to the Wild Horse Saloon at this moment, going to the show.
Oh.
It's written by a fellow named... Troy Olsen.
Yep.
He's wrote for like Tim McGraw and all sorts
Boots
of things.
Boots Lee.
Yeah.
Boots Lee. He's a good mate of ours.
Yeah.
You know Boots Lee.
Troy's a good fellow as well. I mean, he gave us permission to do this song. Some of
and we love it. You know, it's so nice.
Well, a friend of mine, Troy from Acacia Camp, so you have the accent we wish we had. So, well, thank you.
It's a lovely accent. So tell us, what brought
Did you
know
Australia?
Anything about Oz before you came here?
No.
Did you think kangaroos everywhere and, you know, Outback Jack?
The only sort of influence or anything I can get from Australia's media, yeah. or like say movies and such. So you had Crocodile Dundee.
That ain't a knife.
The man from Stan Weber.
You said I did. My American accent. We had a teacher from America over.
All girls school.
All girls school. So I go, yeah, I'm American too. He goes, where do you come from? I said, Texas, California.
Texas, California.
They're two different states. I said, yeah, my mother started having me in Texas, and I was born in California.
This is we are so honoured on 96.5 Inner FM to welcome Chris Boots Lee and Billy Mack, the boys in a band. Take it away from them. Listening to the CD, mate, you are unreal. And Billy, smooth on the guitar.
Friend Ray Whitlock in America, who's probably on his way to the Wild Horse Saloon at this moment, going to the show. It's written by a fellow named Troy Olson. Yeah, Troy's a good fellow as well. I mean, he gave us permission to do this song and some of his other catalog, and it's a great song because I like giving credit where credit's due. Because I believe everybody in this business, whether the listeners, presenters, and musicians, they all have their important part. So it's a good song that gives credit to the people like Bill here who back me up, who make everything work.
But
I wasn't the chubby kid, but you know, boys used to sit on the fence and sing because I had pussycat glasses, and they used to sit on the fence and sing pussycat, we hate you.
That'd be fashionable, wouldn't it?
And threw rocks at me.
I still throw rocks at Edwards, I'm telling you now. You've got to keep her in line. So we've got some live music that you're going to do today. Will we play one off of the CD, or do you want to just do the live stuff? Because
we thought about doing the current single, Boys in the Band, since you girls kind of like that one.
We love it.
It's actually my fourth album, if you count the singles and such. Yeah.
And what a gorgeous album it is.
Thank you.
You must be proud of that, because we get a lot of feedback about playing your songs. And tell us what love brought you to Australia. Like, how did this come about? Because you're a long way from home.
Well, get on MySpace, if you remember MySpace back in the old days. I just got out of a relationship and I was feeling a bit low, and just so happened that my future present wife now, she had a problem where she couldn't sleep because she had the same problem, and so she's kind of going through. And I had a photograph I'd taken with an old band we was playing with and did a lot of covers, classic rock and such. And we practiced a lot. We never played anywhere. That type of situation. But we did get together for a photo. So I took that photo and I pasted it and had a picture of me standing in this big lightning field and such. And but she thought the picture was interesting, so she sent me a message. No, no.
Did
no.
you think kangaroos everywhere and you know, Outback Jack?
The only sort of influence or anything I can get from Australia is from media. Yeah. Or like say movies and such, so you had Crocodile Dundee, and they have the same weather. So it's, I think most of my friends and family in America probably still think I live in Whoop Whoop somewhere in the bush.
Yeah.
I mean, but it's basically everybody's the same wherever you go. They have the same needs and wants.
For us in high school, was Mr. Wood, what I did.
Oh,
my American accent. We had a teacher from America over.
All-girls school?
All-girls school. So I go, yeah, I'm American too. He goes, where do you come from? I said, Texas, California.
Texas,
he said,
California.
They're two different states. I said, yeah, my mother started having me in Texas, and I was born in California.
We went to school.
That was a long way there.
It's an honour to have Chris Bootsley in the studio.
I can't believe it. I've got to get your autograph.
Oh, no. We feel, you know, we feel like we...
right across my forehead.
I can arrange
watch
that.
Out she doesn't try and lose her eyelashes. She'll be feeling around for them. These are all good. Please be quiet and drill somewhere else. I'll come and drill your heads off. They're terrified you see it.
Yeah, they gave you one little bit of
a little bit more. Yes, hello.
Hello, girls. It's me, Rosa.
Rosa, long time no hear.
I'm so excited. When Chrisley was singing Elvis Presley, the girdle, my elastic in my girdle just snapped.
The elastic in your girdle snapped.
Yeah, and I came up with this great idea. Chris, you're a spunky man.
Thank you.
My Giuseppe, right, I was thinking, he could join you. We'll call him Giuseppe. A great idea. Then he'll have a couple of gigs because he's going to sing with the Robert too.
Is he? Now, Boots, what do you say about Giuseppe joining the Chris Boots Lee?
Can he play drums or bass?
No, he last night had a bit of an accident. I made him in a strain of soup and he ate with the spoon. His electric spoon, not the prettiest Chris Lee, a Boots show. He has to wear the jeans. No cowboy hat because he's got a funny head.
Well, that's fine. You can go to Costco and get some nice stretchy denim jeans. It'll be fine.
Well, at the moment, he's in the chicken coop. The rooster not like him. And I said, Giuseppe, the rooster not like you, because he's got more hair than you. It's a hairy chicken. Well, I must go out because I have to go out with the broom. The rooster is attacking my Giuseppe.
The rooster's attacking Giuseppe, isn't it?
See,
see. There's a little head pecked, eh?
Just slightly. Boots, who inspired you musically, you know, when you were growing up? Who were you listening to?
I listened to everything. I'm listening to Great Pretender from the Platters, Little GTO, Ronnie Daytona's, Elvis Presley, Chuck Berry, Buddy Holly, went to some Kiss, Sabbath, Poison. I'm out. If it's positive music, I listen to people and I enjoy all sorts.
And it is.
You remind me of Kenny Rogers.
Before the facelift.
Before the facelift.
No, in the 80s. With the Wild Girls.
Susie and Miss Chrissy. And we have Mr. Chris Boots Lee in the house. I'm trying to find...
And
my
Willie.
Yeah, I was getting to it. Billy Mack.
Willie.
She'll make up a name.
He's right deep in Nashville there, and he's the one sends me the material for the albums and such, and he does some writing himself, and he's probably actually playing the Wild Horse at the moment.
I would like to play, maybe I'll play a track from the CD. Susie, you pass me yours. We play something, we've got four minutes. Hurry up, Kavara, we've got 4 minutes.
Jesus,
I could have mowed the lawn by the time she got that out.
Well, you got to look after
what track? It. What track are we playing? Well, that's Chris Boots Lee from his Crank It Up album. Get out and buy it. Get on his website,
www.chrisbootslee.com.
Boots, thank you very much.
You.
Billy Mack, thank you for playing the
time. No, thank you for having us, ladies.
I'm going to still call
Willie.
Willie Mack?
You can call me Willie Mack if you like.